Today's Tuesday, the 29th of November, and I'm reporting from Durban from the 17th Conference of Parties, which began yesterday. Today we started the business of the agenda for the 17th Conference and the subsidiary body on implementation, the subsidiary body on science technology assessments. Again, we had statements from the various groups and major countries being read. We haven't really gone into the substantive negotiations yet. They'll start tomorrow. But a lot of other events are taking place here in parallel, lots and lots of side events, some of them extremely interesting. There are thousands of people attending the COP, young people, civil society, private sector. These events are not just about climate negotiations, the official negotiations. Of the 10,000 or so people in Durban at the COP, maybe only 2,000 or 3,000 are actual government officials and negotiators. Many of the others come for a variety of reasons. There are lots of exhibitions going on, stands, publications, side events, and all kinds of other events, not just at the COP, but around Durban City. So it's an occasion for a lot of people to share information, network, meet each other, and of course at the core of it is the negotiations, but it's not all about the negotiations. The negotiations, as I said, are going to a fairly slow start. People are coming up with their opening gambits or statements, which are fairly hardline. The trick is going to be to find the area of compromise across these various hard lines. We had a bit of theater from the Canadians, from the Canadian government, who made an announcement in Canada that they would withdraw from the Kyoto Protocol, which would be an extremely bad sign. It would certainly be a bad sign about Canadian participation in these kinds of international negotiations, where they refuse to abide by agreements that they have made in good faith. In fact, it calls into question their good faith in these negotiations. But it may well be a ploy. We shall see when the official negotiators from Canada actually tell us what they really meant. It may have been just a political statement from the minister back home. But these are the kinds of things that happen in the COPs. We see political statements being made. On the other hand, we see on the inside negotiation track some compromise language emerging. It all depends to a very large extent on the skills and abilities of the host country as the president of the COP. The South Africans certainly have the skills, and we hope that they'll be able to bring an element of compromise across all the different points of view that are represented here and are in the beginning are being presented as firm positions, but obviously those firm positions are not going to find their way into final agreement unless people are willing to compromise. And the art of getting an agreement is to elicit that compromise from the major players in this. So it all remains open and to play for, and we shall see what unfolds over the next 2 weeks in Durban.